Westminster Shorter Catechism, question and answer 14, reads as follows. What is sin? Sin is any want of conformity unto or transgression of the law of God. It's important for us to recognize, as we were talking about previously from Psalm 19, that the law of the Lord is the perfect standard to teach us on what we are to believe concerning God and the duty that God requires of us. The law of God, then, is the only rule that we are to go to, that we are to use, that we are to receive as the standard by which we are to judge what sin is and what righteousness is. And the confession here tells us in a very helpful way what sin is. It is any lack of conformity unto or a transgression of the law of God. We might describe this in two ways. First of all, the want of conformity. These are sometimes called sins of omission. That is to say, sins that pertain to things that we should have done that we failed to do. There are many things that we are called to do, that God commands us to do, that we don't do, that we fail to do. And then there are other things that are direct affronts to the law of God. These sins are sins of commission. These are actual transgressions of the law of God, where God explicitly says, do not do this, and we do it. The scriptures teach us in a very powerful but clear way in 1 John chapter 3, verse 4, what sin is. Everyone who makes a practice of sinning also practices lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. Sin is human action that is contrary to the law of God. And there are at least two ways to sin contrary to the law of God. Either we neglect to do something we ought to do, or we do something that we ought not to do. Sins of omission and sins of commission. They are both equally sin. And this definition that is given to us here of what sin is very helpful for us, because in order to understand our need for the gospel, first we need to understand what our need is as sinners. And it will be impossible for us to understand something of the breadth and the length and the depth, the riches of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, just how awesome, wide, big, and deep it is, without first understanding how wide, big, and deep our own sinfulness is. And to understand that God's law is that standard by which we judge what is sin and what is righteousness will help us tremendously, if we're honest with ourselves, to see our total depravity in order that we might flee to God's grace in order to find full redemption for that sin and sinfulness that is ours.